Hello everybody, welcome to our Tech Talk Live. Today we will talk about the Amira Live System, which is part of our ARI Cinematic Multicam activities. We are going to start with a quick introduction on what the Amira Live System is about, and then our Multicam expert Thomas will walk you through the basic setup and configuration of the system. This will be a recorded session. After that, we will have Q&A, and Thomas will give us some insights on some Multicam production he was involved in. So let's start on the overview. Amira Live is a new product in our cinematic Multicam offerings. It combines the Amira camera body with an integrated fiber adapter, which connects the camera to the base station or CCU with a SEM-T311 fiber cable. The system is specifically designed for live multi-camera applications. There is no external cabling between the camera body and the fiber camera adapter. That allows a faster setup. It has a reduced risk of accidental cable disconnection or damage. And it is a cleaner camera configuration, easier to work with for camera operators. All in all, a system camera like cable-less design, clean, uncluttered, and reliable. So perfect for live broadcast environments. Part of the system is a system camera style monitor to allow typical operation like on a studio pedestal. It includes controls for typical monitor settings, a switch for front side tele, camera user buttons, and more. For camera remote control, we have integrated the next generation RCP V2 from Skahoy. This allows classical RCP operation like with traditional RCPs, but on top of that offers functionality and workflow opportunities far beyond. It is fully configurable, it offers full replication of a Sony RCP, and it supports ARRI CAP protocol with various camera functions which are not covered by regular RCPs, which is like rec start stop, playback start stop, or loading and saving looks or setup files and more. But at the end, it's all about the best image quality. So here is an example how a live spot event can look like when using the ARRI Multicam system. Impressive stuff. So now comes Thomas with the setup of the system, with how to configure it, how to connect it, and how to make the basic settings for working with the system. Then.
Hello, welcome to our ARRI Tech Talk Live. My name is Thomas Doschek, and I'm working at ARRI as a sales manager. Today, we'd like to introduce you to our new Amira Live Cinematic Multicam system. And here on the right, you see the new Amira Live consisting out of the body, our studio monitor VMM1, our control panel CCP1, the RCP, and the base station. And how everything has to be set up and to connect together, we will show you now. We are starting with the base station. on the base station you have different connectors, and I will explain you how to use. So starting with the SMPTE fiber connector, here you could interconnect the camera body with the base station. Beside, you find the program audio output. It's an analog audio stereo output where you can get the microphone or any other line level from the camera out of the base station. As next, you have these four channels called video 1, video 2, 3, and 4. On these four channels, you get, depending on what kind of mode you are driving, different signals. In the classical HD mode, you will get on video 1 and video 3 an HD SDI signal. If you are driving the system in UHD mode, you will get out there a 4x3G signal. As follows, there are two 12G single link connectors. These both connectors can provide additional HD outputs, or if you configure a dual 6G or a single link 12G output. Depends on the mode you drive at the camera. HD SDI 1 and HD SDI 2 are monitor outputs in case you are using the UHD monitor, UHD mode. Return HD SDI is the input for the return video signal. Below, you will find the return VBS. Return VBS is the path for the teleprompter. It's an analog signal. As next, you will find the AES audio, where you get, in parallel to the analog audio, an AES out, or if you like, you also can configure this output in a different way. The next both connectors are the Genlog input and loop through. And monitor VBS 1 and 2 allows you to pass an analog video signal from the camera to the base station. LANC is not in use, and TCIO is a configurable in or output where you can run the timecode through or from the camera to the base station. On the remote RS-422 input, you can connect an RCP, for example, a Sony RCP, serial to the base station to control the camera. Below, you find the connector for the intercom. Tele preview is the input to provide a tele to the system, and you can drive green or red tele. RS-232 and RS-485 are inputs for a data connection to the camera. The both inputs, camera and ARRI, which are a RJ45 connector, are in use when you are working with a Sony RCP. If we are only connect our RCP, you need only the camera one input. Now we are moving forward with the remote control panel. The remote control panel is shipped with a special programming cable and an additional power supply. But you also can power the RCP via a PoE switch. On the back side of the RCP, you find a rotary switch where you can adjust the camera number on the display of the RCP, the power in connector, the RJ45 connector, which connects the RCP via the base station to the camera, and an additional sub-D connector. With this sub-D connector, we provide tele to the RCP, and you get a joystick override contact out of the RCP, and at least the programming connector for the USB cable. Now we have a look at the camera body. On the camera body, we have mounted our 10-inch studio monitor, the VMM1. The VMM1 owns a special tele light on the top. Then we have a display which provides the actual camera number, an interface which is direct connected to the viewfinder output of the camera, a power supply, an additional SDI input with this loop-through output, and an external tele-in, where you can provide an external tele-in for red and green tele. In this setup, the monitor is looped through our camera control panel, the CCP1, which allows us to set up the camera if we don't want to use a web browser interface. The body itself has an integrated fiber adapter, and on the fiber adapter we have different connectors. So you find an SDI video monitor output, two connections for an intercom headset, an additional viewfinder or teleprompter connector, an AUX output, a remote output, and a power in if you like to power the camera with an external power supply. And of course our SMPTE cable connector. To set up the communication between the RCP, the base station, and the camera, I have to adjust the IP addresses on the different devices. So let's start with the base station. In the combination with our RCP, a special IP address is not needed. We just have to configure a bypass mode. Therefore, I have to go to the menu and select the network menu and adjust the Ethernet mode to bypass. This is done. I have now to configure the RCP. To configure the RCP, I need a laptop, the firmware updater from Skahoy, and the USB cable. If everything is connected, I open the configurator, select IP configuration, and now I start to configure the IP addresses. I have to be taking care of the IP addresses because I have to configure two different IP addresses. One of them is the RCP IP address, which is related to the SSCP address of the camera, and the both on the bottom are related to the static IP address of the camera. If this is done, I have now to adjust the IP address at the camera. In the user interface of the camera, I started with setting the network address of the static IP address of the camera. If this is done, I have to adjust the SSCP address and to activate the multicam mode. And please don't forget to load the multicam mode look and to set the CAP password. Before we start our Q&A session, I like to share some pictures about our last production where I had the luck to join in the last 6 months. The first I like to report is a 10-camera magical show which was produced for the RTL group in Germany, and the show called Ehrlich Brothers Magic Show. And what you see is one of the six Amiras we had in use, and additional four minis. And it was the first show here in Germany where 10 ARRI Multicam systems were involved. And also we used some Cine lenses, and the SIH3 and everything was live recorded on tape. So it was a very, very, very good start to bring a new look to the German television. And since we did this kind of show, we got more and more requests for other productions. The second production was completely different because the amount of cameras was not so important. It was more the way how we had to control this application. It was a 6-camera production for a David Guetta show in Dubai, happened on the Burj Al Arab on the helipad platform. And there we used 2 Amiras and 2 Alexa Minis and 2 drones. The drones wasn't equipped with ARRI cameras, but the rest was a completely remote production because the control room was fitted in a 1.5 floor down the helipad, and we had to remote control everything because it was not allowed to have anybody on the helipad because of our corona regulations. And you see, it was a perfect environment for a multicam system because of the different lighting situation, because the concert happened in the evening and went forward until it was dark, and you had such a nice view from the Burj Al Arab, and you see all the contrasts, and we had some LED walls, so it was a really, really nice production. From both of these productions you find some showreel links and also an interview from the directors and the DOPs who are talking about the different productions. I think it might be very interesting to you. Another test we did was the first camera during a live football game. So we used the Amira in combination with the first worldwide available box PL lens, and we made a test and recorded a lot of nice footage, and I'm happy to share this footage the next time with you. And in combination of this event, because this event was the final of the DFB final in Berlin 2 weeks ago, we also had a mini in a multicam system available. And this mini was also live on air. And how it looks like, because it's a new trend which is coming up, and I think we will see such a kind of pictures the next time more and more, you can see now in our clip. Oh, Yeah, so I think this clip shows that we will get more and more new images for a sports event, especially in the football games. And many thanks to TVN, who supported us with the image and with the showreel. And many thanks to the DFB, who allowed us to use this material. Yeah, so now I think it's time for our Q&A session. So Markus, are there any questions?
All right, we have a couple of questions indeed. So first of all, how can the camera number on the camera number display be set? Inside the camera or via RCP? So I think the question is about the camera number on the viewfinder monitor.
Camera number on the monitor has to be adjusted in the menu of the monitor itself.
Okay, thank you. What are the differences between the multicam and the general color profiles looks?
Can you maybe explain a little bit more?
I think I have only the question, but I think it's about the colorimetry or the color science. So maybe I can answer that directly. So the colors, the color science and everything is totally different, is totally identical on both the multicam and the normal looks. So you can use any look for multicam purposes and vice versa, that there's no difference. And you can modify the colors and the parameters and everything in both in the same way.
Yeah.
That's the only thing you have to consider, but that's a very detail, is that once you select a look, you don't select a factory default look, because then you cannot modify the parameter. So you need to copy that look and use it then in a multicam environment.
And I think that is a very important information, because in the past we had some customers who forgot to copy their look and was wondering why they can't modify it.
You're all safe if you select a multicam look, but again, it's the same look, same image. So it that's the beauty of the multicam system, of our multicam system, is that when you modify the colors with your RCP, you're modifying the colors in the heart, in the core of the camera. So you're not putting something behind the signal, but you're modifying the signal itself inside the camera, inside of the color processing of the camera.
Okay.
Okay?
Yeah.
All right, what do we have else? How do I configure the camera without a viewfinder? So there's the monitor, but how would I do that without the monitor?
So there are two ways. First, you can use, if the wireless or the Wi-Fi power is switched on, you can do it via your handy or an iPad, which is connected via Wi-Fi to the camera. Or if you have a connection via LAN or, to the via and a PC, then you can open just the web browser, type in the IP address of the static IP address of the camera, and you will get the web browser, and then you can modify the adjustments.
Or what we saw in the little video is you use the CCP1 for modification.
For example, as well. So if I have an CCP1, I can daisy chain it between the viewfinder output of the camera and also and the monitor, and then I have the access to the menu.
Okay, what's next? So what kind of lenses can I use with the system? I think we saw one nice lens. Maybe you want to say a word on that PL yeah. box lens, which is quite an impressive thing.
Absolutely. So, like everybody knows, we have a different kind of mounts for the camera. So we have EF mount, we have a PL mount, we have a B4 mount. That means all this kind of lenses could be used with the Amira Live. And if you have box lenses, for example, in the last picture I had shown, maybe I can bring it back, you need a special large lens adapter, which allows you to use to connect the lens mechanically to the camera, because it's a very heavy lens. And this lens, like I mentioned before, it's a PL box lens, which starts by 35 millimeters and ends by 700, and has an internal extender with 1.5, 1.4, it means your end range is 980 millimeters. This lens is very heavy because it's PL. It means, I think, if I remember right, the weight of the lens itself was 30 kilo. But all these kind of lenses and also box lenses with a B4 mount can be connected to the camera. So there's no limitation.
Right, I think important to add that you, with all these lenses, you can remote control the iris with your RCP, though. That's all
correct.
Possible with all the different lens types. Last questions I have received here on my list is, can I also use other RCPs than the Skahoy one?
So with the Skahoy RCP, we have the deepest implementation to our protocol. But of course, I can also use a Sony RCP. We have a built-in translator in our base station, and that allows us to use a Sony RCP, but with more limited functions.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much.
Please let us know and follow up our next tech talks. And of course, let us know if you have further questions. We will answer you per email. And also, please give us your ideas or let us know what are your suggestions and wishes for the next tech talk when we do more special setups with the camera. Thank you and goodbye.